السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، يقول الله عز وجل في سورة الإسراء في الآية 11 من هذه السورة: ويدعو الإنسان بالشر دعاءه بالخير وكان الإنسان عجولا. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة الإسراء this surah number 17 in ayah number 11 from this surah he says what it means: and the man or the human being supplicates for evil as he supplicates for good, and the man is hasty. This is an indication that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attracts our attention to a fact that sometimes when we get angry and we get upset with some of the behaviors of any family members, so the shaitan immediately tempts and incites the person to, instead of making dua for them to be guided, he makes dua against them. And that's what Allah says in this ayah. He says, وَيَدْعُ الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاءَهُ بِالْخَيْرِ. The man supplicates for evil the same way that he supplicates for good. And he concludes the ayah by saying, and the man is hasty. Which means that he hastens things. He wants things to happen in a minute. Guidance to come as quick as that. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees everything. As long as the Muslim is doing his job in teaching, educating his family members, and exerting all the efforts, whatever is required from him, he should have a trust and confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah azza wa jal will make it easy and Allah azza wa jal will guide him. Might take some time, but eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he promised in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. Indeed, Allah Azza wa Jal will not waste the reward and the compensation of the one who is doing good. Allah Azza wa Jal will not waste his efforts. And that reminds us with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he indicates that your dua will be accepted no matter what, whether you make dua for them or against them. He says, لا تدعوا على أنفسكم ولا على أموالكم ولا على أولادكم. He said, do not make dua against yourselves, against your families, against your children, or against your wealth. It might coincide with the time that the gates of the heavens are open and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept this dua. يوافق ساعة إجابة فيستجيب الله له. This is very interesting story, a true story that happened in the Masjid al-Haram, like next to the Kaaba. You know, around the Kaaba, there are these soldiers that they are organizing the people, and especially at the place of al-Hajar al-Aswad. Between the corner in which al-Hajar al-Aswad, the black stone, is, and the door of the Kaaba, this area is about 2 meters. What they call this area? What is it known? It is known as Al-Multazam. This special space in the Kaaba is called Al-Multazam. And the dua is, subhanAllah, accepted in this area. So this soldier who happened to be in this place, there was a man, by the way, it's reported from the Prophet ﷺ and his companions, that they used to make dua at this special spot. Next to the Kaaba, in Al-Multazam area. So this man, he was making dua, and this soldier was very close to him, and he could hear what he was saying. He was saying, Allahumma a'tini waladan, anta a'tayta an-nasa jami'an waladan, walam tu'tini walad, fa'tini walad. He made dua this way. He said, oh Allah, you have given everyone a son or a boy, like a child, and you did not give me one. Wallah, give me one. He made this dua and then left. And then this soldier said, after 18 years, the same man came to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was making dua in the same exact spot. كان يقول في دعائه اللهم إني هذا الرجل كان يدعو ويقول اللهم إني أسألك أن تهلك ولدي. After 18 years, بعد 18 عام, he came to the same spot and he was making this dua saying, oh Allah, I ask you to destroy my son. So that soldier hurt him. Then he took him out of that spot. أخذه بعيدا. ثم حدثه وقال له, لماذا تدعو بهذا الدعاء? Why do you make this dua? Then he told him about the deviation, the misguidance, the bad things, the evil things that his son is doing, and the big trouble that he is doing, he is putting him in. Then this soldier told him, listen, لقد ظلمت ولدك مرتين. You have made a mistake against your son two times. You have wronged your son two times. He said, how? He said, the first time I heard you when you were making dua to Allah Azza wa Jal, you said, اللهم أعطني ولدا ولم تقل اللهم أعطني ولدا صالحا. He said, the first time when you were making dua, you said, oh Allah, give me a son or a boy, a child. And you did not say, oh Allah, give me a pious, righteous, good child. You were supposed to say that. Like the dua of Zakariya alayhi salam, the dua of the prophets, and the dua of everyone. Allahu Rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyyatina qurrata a'yun. So he said, this is the first time that you wronged your son. And the second time you wronged him, when you came to the same spot making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy your son, whereas you're supposed to make dua for him to be guided. The man subhanallah listened to the advice of this soldier and he said, Jazakallah khairan for advising me. And this soldier said, I made a way for him to go back to the same spot, to Al-Multazam, and to make dua. And he made dua for his son to be guided and to be on the right path. He said, the following year, he came to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, came for the Umrah, and he came with his son. Came with his son. And then his son was a very good boy, was guided on the right path, very pious, very righteous, good, obedient servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, this son said to this soldier, he said, wallahi, the time that my dad, my father, was making dua for me to be guided in this spot, it was the exact time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me to the right path. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَيَدْعُ الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاءَهُ بِالْخَيْرِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. We are always in haste and we want things to happen in a second. It takes some time. وَلِذَلِكَ مَنْ عَصَى أَوْ مَنْ اسْتَعْصَى عَلَيْهِ هِدَايَةِ وَلَدِهِ فَيَفْعَلْ وَيَقُولْ كَمَا فَعَلَ الْفُضَيْلِ ابْنِ عِيَاطِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ. Whoever has hard time with his kids or with his children to be guided will do the same thing as Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi did. His son, yani we're talking about the most pious, righteous person, but his son was in the wrong direction completely. He guided him. He advised him. He taught him. He talked to him. It didn't work. But you know what the dua that he made at this time? He said, Allahumma inni ajastu عن تأديب ولدي وإصلاحه فأدبه لي. He made this dua. He said, اللهم إني عجزت عن إصلاح ولدي وتأديبه أو عن تأديب ولدي فأدبه لي. He said, oh Allah, I am unable to fix my son and to correct his behavior. Please do it for me. And subhanallah, his son became قرة عين له. He continued making this dua until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made his son one of the most pious and righteous people. It is even reported that he became one of the scholars due to the dua of his father. So never ever be in haste. And always remember that Allah will not waste the efforts. And always remember we are going to be questioned and asked about the efforts and the work, not about the result. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us for the efforts that we make. So we should never give up. We continue doing what we are doing. We make dua for our children. We make dua for ourselves, for our families, instead of getting angry and making dua against ourselves or against our children. Because remember, the dua of the parents for or against the children will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى الهداية والرشاد. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right way and to the straight path and to make all of us from those who listen to the words and follow the best of them. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afaf wa al-ghina wa min al-amali ma tafba rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك املنا وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، اشهد ان لا اله الا انت، استغفرك واتوب اليك. والعصر، ان الانسان لفي خسر الا الذين امنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خيرا.